Decades come and go, but the movies are forever. Cinema, as a medium of storytelling and artistic expression, has a long history of exploring the mysterious and profound realm of sleep and dreams. Across the decades, filmmakers have harnessed the visual, auditory, and narrative power of sleep to craft stories that delve into the human psyche, emotions, and imagination. This video embarks on a comprehensive journey through cinema's evolving portrayal of sleep to analyze how filmmakers have employed sleep as a thematic and narrative device. The nascent years of cinema, marked by silent films, offered a modest glimpse into the portrayal of sleep. Sleep scenes, though rudimentary, often served as simple transition points in the narrative. Characters were shown going to bed or waking up to advance the storyline, but the narrative potential of sleep had yet to be fully realized. However, glimpses of cinematic dreamscapes emerged with filmmakers like Georges Méliès. His groundbreaking work, A Trip to the Moon, laid the foundation for the fantastical possibilities of cinematic dreams. With its fantastical portrayal of a lunar voyage, including an otherworldly vision of the moon with a face, stars, and other dreamlike characteristics, the film is said to be an early representation of Freud's theory of dreams, hinting at the potential for dream sequences and surreal visuals in film. The transition from silent films to talkies in the 1930s marked a watershed moment in cinema history. Sound brought a newfound dimension to the depiction of sleep. Filmmakers could now explore sleep through dialogue, sound effects, and music, enriching the auditory and emotional aspects of sleep portrayal. Dream sequences evolved, heightening the dreamlike quality of sleep with musical scores and surreal elements, blurring reality and dreams in films of the 1930s. An exemplary representation of this evolved portrayal of sleep in the 1930s is found in The Wizard of Oz. The movie commences in a black and white world, transitioning into a vibrant and musical dreamland post a tornado-induced dream sequence. Dorothy, the central character, grapples with discerning between the realms of dream and reality. The film adeptly evokes common dream experiences, infusing the dream world with magical elements like talking trees and flying monkeys. Familiar figures from Dorothy's reality seamlessly transform into essential characters in her dream, such as Mrs. Gulch adopting the persona of the Wicked Witch, while her family members embody the Scarecrow, Tin Man, and Lion, aiding her in navigating the dream's obstacles. These elements intensify the audience's emotional immersion in Dorothy's dream journey, highlighting the intricacies of her dream world, often challenging to convey upon awakening. The 1950s witnessed a surge in the popularity of the film noir genre, which brought about new ways in which sleep depiction could be utilized to create dark and brooding atmospheres. Sleeplessness, dark dreams, and restless nights portrayed characters' existential angst and vulnerability, reflecting post-war societal anxieties. Characters' faces were often partially obscured in shadow, creating a sense of foreboding even in moments of slumber. Film noir went beyond narrative, however, incorporating blurred realities that mixed dreams and hallucinations, expressionistic lighting, and unreliable narration to deepen sleep portrayal. An exemplary instance is Salvador Dali and Alfred Hitchcock's collaboration in Spellbound, crafted for sleep psychoanalysis. The noir film explores Constance Peterson's quest to unravel John Ballantyne's neurosis and clear him of murder. The dream sequence, a noir masterpiece, employs Dali's surreal noir techniques to blur dream, reality, and hallucination, utilizing all manners of the decade's techniques of sleep portrayal, including dark chiaroscuro lighting and unreliable narration. While psychoanalytic theory has long been accused of lacking a firm scientific basis, revolutionary discoveries have been made on the nature of sleep and dreaming since the release of the 1945 film, confirming that these discoveries, like neurobiological waking processes, support psychoanalysis. The spellbound sequence, with its flowing curtains, distorted imagery, and enigmatic symbols, showcased the evolving potential of cinematic dreamscapes in the 40s and 50s for dark artistic expression and psychological exploration. The 1960s and 1970s witnessed the emergence of counterculture movements and a wave of surrealism and experimentation in cinema. Filmmakers began to explore dreamlike states influenced by psychedelia and the changing social landscape, with depicted dreams becoming fragmented, mirroring the era's upheavals. Stanley Kubrick's film 2001. A Space Odyssey delves into metaphysical themes, linking sleep, dreams, and space exploration. The Stargate sequence in particular showcases cinema's ability to create an otherworldly experience akin to a dream. This scene blurs the lines between wakefulness and slumber, immersing viewers in a cosmic dreamscape with vibrant colors and distorted space. While the film explores altered states of consciousness, symbolized by surreal imagery, it's more an artistic representation of altered awareness than a scientifically accurate portrayal of sleep and dreams. Despite not providing precise scientific explanations, its captivating journey into the surreal aligns with the cinematic trends of that era. The 1980s marked the rise of sleep as a central theme in horror and fantasy genres. A Nightmare on Elm Street introduced an iconic villain, Freddy Krueger, who terrorized teenagers in their dreams. The film elevated sleep to a central theme, portraying nightmarish dreamscapes and the blurring of dream and reality. Freddy Krueger's ability to infiltrate the dreams of his victims tapped into primal fears of vulnerability and the loss of control while asleep. The film's imaginative dream sequences, which often defied the laws of physics and reality, showcased the potential for creative and terrifying visuals in sleep depiction. It creatively explores dream-induced events affecting the waking world, emphasizing that death in dreams mirror reality. While it delves into psychological themes and their link to sleep, the film leans toward fantastical horror. It vividly visualizes subconscious dangers, reflecting societal fears about the mind's vulnerability during sleep. Echoing sleep disorders and trauma's impact, the movie resonates with psychological implications. Despite its fictional nature, the storyline was inspired by real incidents involving Southeast Asian refugees plagued by severe nightmares, influencing the film's genesis. Fantasy films like Labyrinth use dreams as a means of escape from harsh realities. The film's dreamlike sequences, filled with mythical creatures and allegorical elements, invited audiences to explore the transformative power of imagination and the coping mechanisms of its young protagonist. Sarah ventures into her dreams after making a wish, encountering mythical creatures and symbolic elements. These sequences symbolize the potency of imagination and coping mechanisms, with the labyrinth embodying her desire for freedom from parental constraints. Sarah's journey through the maze signifies her growth and maturity, representing her triumph over life's challenges. Despite the absence of explicit sleep-wake transitions, the film hints at a dream-like realm through psychological and narrative elements, featuring talking hands and walls. Labyrinth portrays dreams as a space where transitioning adolescents grapple with self-discovery, blurring reality, and the subconscious. The advent of the 1990s witnessed a surge in scientific advancements in comprehending sleep disorders, such as narcolepsy, accompanied by the emergence of multiple theoretical frameworks on sleep. This burgeoning knowledge became a wellspring of inspiration for the film industry, prompting extensive experimentation with sleep disorders as integral psychological narrative devices. Fight Club stands as a prime example of films from this era that ingeniously employed a sleep disorder as a central plot element. Throughout much of the film, Edward Norton's character grapples with chronic insomnia, a condition that profoundly affects his life. As the narrative unfolds, the protagonist's insomnia intensifies, and his connection to reality grows increasingly fragile. Yet, it's not until the film's climax that the revelation emerges. He suffers from dissociative identity disorder, giving rise to a distinct personality that only he sees, Brad Pitt's character, Tyler Durden. This realization comes at a point when he is experiencing severe sleep deprivation, highlighting the destructive consequences of his dual identity. According to a 2014 study, individuals with dissociative identity disorder often contend with heightened sleep problems and reduced sleep quality. This can shed light on the protagonist's early behavior in the film and the roots of his insomnia, ultimately serving as a cautionary tale to audiences that sleep disorders should never be trivialized, as they can serve as potential markers of more serious underlying medical conditions. The early 2000s functioned as a transition period of ever-growing knowledge about sleep science that pushed sleep depiction boundaries from shocking plot twists in the 1990s, as seen in Fight Club, into full-blown mind-bending realities in the 2010s, as seen in films such as Inception. During this transition period, the film industry began crafting entire plots revolving exclusively around different concepts of sleep, both scientific and philosophical, and how these sleep concepts intersect with reality. While films such as Eternal Sunshine of the Spotless Mind and Waking Life are noteworthy examples from this period, 2004's The Machinist stands out as a paramount representative of this transitional phase of increasingly blurred boundaries between sleep and reality. The film features Christian Bale as the main character grappling with a year-long battle against insomnia, which leaves him emaciated and psychologically vulnerable. Following an unfortunate accident involving a colleague, he spirals into a disorienting world where distinguishing reality from delusion becomes increasingly challenging. While most real-life insomnia sufferers won't face such extreme consequences, a 2009 study notably affirmed the commonality of insomnia symptoms among individuals with high levels of paranoia and delusions, leaving the extreme nature of the film's presentation to serve as a stark reminder that the effects of insomnia and, by extension, other facets of sleep, psyche, and one's perception of reality can be profoundly unsettling. In the digital age, the reemergence of science fiction as a popular genre among moviegoers and the advancements in filmmaking technology expanded the possibilities of sleep depiction in cinema. Inception, 2010, directed by Christopher Nolan, delved into the manipulation of dreams and the concept of shared dreaming. The film's intricate narrative and mind-bending visuals pushed the boundaries of reality and imagination. The movie navigates the terrain of lucid dreaming, where individuals retain awareness within their dream world, exercising control over their dreamscapes. Cobb, the protagonist, uses a totem to discern between dream and reality, symbolizing the film's exploration of conscious perception. Director Nolan constructs an elaborate dream realm, introducing shared dreaming, enabling characters to delve into one another's dreams for critical intel. While the film draws from Freudian subconscious theories, highlighting the potential to access profound knowledge during dreaming, it doesn't firmly adhere to scientific dream mechanics. Nevertheless, Inception aptly captures the mysterious and surreal essence of dreams, aligning with modern scientific beliefs, suggesting that dreams facilitate cognitive processing and information organization in the brain. The history of sleep depiction in cinema is a testament to the medium's ability to capture the essence of the human experience. From the silent era to the digital age, filmmakers have used sleep as a narrative device, a canvas for artistic expression, and a means to delve into the complexities of the human psyche. As cinema continues to evolve, the portrayal of sleep remains an enduring theme, inviting audiences to embark on a cinematic journey through the dreamscapes of the silver screen. Each decade has contributed its own unique perspective, reflecting the cultural, social, and technological shifts of the time, serving as a testament to the medium's boundless creative potential and its capacity to explore the profound and enigmatic aspects of human existence.